She is, by her own admission, bright and bubbly on screen. But behind the scenes, it's been a different story. Toni Street has dealt with crushing grief and extraordinary challenges. There was the loss of three precious siblings, a life-threatening illness, and a surrogacy journey, events which have defined Toni's life and, perhaps surprisingly, shaped her career. Tonight, Toni shares her story of loss, love, and hope.
Oh, yes, just one win stands between Emirates Team New Zealand and retain.
This is what we're used to. Toni Street. Charming. Funny.
Go Emirates Team New Zealand!
But the on-screen warmth hid the reality.
I had nothing left. I was just so ill.
We sat down to discuss it all.
I said to my mum, I'm being sent to die.
The losses.
It's huge, and it's something that you don't just gloss over.
And the incredible gift of love.
Emotions were running high the whole time.
Toni Street, Taranaki born and bred for success.
I had a wonderful childhood, I really did. It was classic growing up on a dairy farm, very sporty family. Very involved parents. If my dad wasn't at the milking shed, he was coaching the cricket team or the rugby team. I had a stay-at-home mum who was there cooking, baking. It was a classic farming upbringing.
Tell me about your parents.
They are quite passionate people. They were the sort of parents that encouraged you to be the best you could be at anything. And as long as we, you know, really gave it our all, they were completely proud of us.
Does it feel like a guiding force now?
Yeah, I think so. Even today, I think if I'm going to start something, I want to give myself the best chance to be good at it. You may as well give it a good crack.
There was a vow that you made to yourself to honour your parents.
Yeah.
What was that?
Well, I was 18 when my brother died, and at that moment my parents had lost three children, and I didn't want to be any form of disappointment to them. Oh, God, okay. And from that moment, I didn't want to make their life any harder in any way. So, yeah, from that point, I just decided, you know, I will be their joy and their light. And hopefully that can make up in some way for the kids that they've lost.
I'm going to offer you a tissue.
Sorry, gosh. It's an early start for me.
It's a vow that has defined Toni's 38 years, splitting it into life before and life after. So tell me about Stephen.
He was gorgeous. He was really cute, very olive skin, big brown eyes, the type of kid that everyone was drawn to and liked.
Stephen was 14 when he went out on a quad bike to help his dad. It rolled, and Toni's precious brother was gone.
So even now, when I think back to our childhood, I find it really hard because every good memory was with him. And I remember the days after, you know, just the sense of, what do we do now? What do we do with ourselves? I remember being in the car and it's the middle of summer and everyone's at the beach and having fun, and you feel like screaming to them, our world's just ended and we'll never have a nice summer again. You just think, nothing's going to be good again.
A defining loss for Toni, but her parents had already been down this path not once, but twice.
For it to happen again was just unbelievable.
Cruel.
It was really cruel, you know. And I know Mum at times in the past has gone, well, we just curse this family in some of her low moments, you know, and I can see why she felt that way.
First, there was Toni's twin brother, Lance.
Different personalities, but fitted very easily together. I think with Lance taking a back seat by the sounds, just letting me rule the roost.
Lance died of leukemia at just 18 months old.
Like, I don't know how Mum and Dad coped with that moment, because you're not just losing a child, you're also losing twins.
Then, a year later, baby sister Tracy.
2 days after Tracy was born, they knew something was wrong, she went blue, and they realised she'd been born without kidneys. And so then Mum and Dad were facing having to, you know, say goodbye to another child.
The loss of Toni's three siblings, Lance, Tracy and Stephen, is often referred to in articles, but fleetingly.
Yes, and I think my mum has perhaps struggled with that a bit over the years, and with me being a public figure, it will be mentioned in passing, you know, a line, Toni had three siblings die. And for a mother who has lost three children, all independently, all real full human lives, that's quite hard to see as just one line. But what's the alternative, you know? The alternative is to write a full dissertation about this tragedy, and, you know, you can't do that, so...
You've done it.
Well, I have now.
For the first time, Toni is telling her whole story in a new book, including the guilt she's carried at being one of two surviving children.
When your parents have lost three children, you start to think, how were we the ones to survive this? I never wanted to be the child for mum and dad when they've already lost three. That was a screw-up and was putting more pressure on them.
So it was a bitter blow when Toni became seriously ill.
I just thought, oh, gosh, here we go again with them having to deal with another issue with one of their children.
Oh, Toni, so you didn't get to sit in your own illness and understand you were worried about your parents.
Well, I would be sitting in these appointments and it was just written all over Mum's face, and I was thinking, oh, God, I hope she doesn't think this is going to be another child she's going to lose.
The truth is, it was close.
They basically said, go home and good luck.
What do you mean?
So I was on the brink of organ failure and they didn't know why, and they didn't know how bad I was going to get or whether I was going to recover.
Did you think that you might die?
I did. I said to my mum, I'm being home sent to die.
About 4 months ago, I was diagnosed with the autoimmune disease, Churg-Strauss, and I didn't want to make a big...
The diagnosis came just in time to save her organs. But the meds were a story of their own.
But I don't know many mechanics that got my gloves.
You just seem so normal. The reality was, at home, it was a whole different picture, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, the drugs that you take and you know that they are trying to put you into remission, they make you go a little bit crazy. You have manic episodes.
Good evening. 8 weeks till Christmas. Oh.
Not that anyone knew. This is Toni at her sickest. We've worked together for a long time.
Yeah.
I had no idea the challenge that you had to rise to.
Yeah.
So you were hiding the worst effects?
Oh, absolutely I was. I think that's human nature to do that too. The worst times you have are always behind closed doors. And I had a public job and I would be on air for half an hour each night. But it's pretty easy to be bright and bubbly for half an hour.
The illness also ended her dream of another pregnancy with husband Matt France.
I put it to the side because I thought, I'm not physically capable of having a third child, so it is what it is, let's move on.
But you didn't?
No, well, because I had this angel in the form of my best friend that decided that she wanted to be a surrogate for us.
Toni and Sophie Braggan's surrogacy story is well documented.
Oh, I owe her everything. I owe her the world. How do you thank someone who's done that for you? You actually can't.
Lockie, who recently turned three, has brought healing in more ways than one.
It's remarkable, really. If you look at photos of Stephen and Lockie side by side, they've got the same olive skin, the same big brown eyes, the same hair. There are so many similarities.
What does it tell you?
I don't know, maybe that someone's watching over us, that I feel like he's a real gift for our family as a whole, you know. And the fact that the brother I lost is so much like him, that can't be an accident. That's how I feel.
Can you go help me put these outside?
It's been a big life. Fame, love and tragedy.
Wallowing in my own grief was never an option for me, never, because that would have hurt my parents more. And why would I want to do that?
The flip side of that is, does it stop you from processing your own grief?
Yeah, I think I don't think I've processed my own grief very well at all.
Do you feel like you are still living with that grief?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
So in a way, making the vow to your parents to be the very best daughter that you can be, the most successful you can in your life, has come at a cost.
Yeah, I think I probably did part my own grief, but I think it's also the way I'm inclined as well.
Have you thought about how you will go forward from now? What does the journey ahead look like for you?
I feel like it's a really freeing type of thing to have all of your story, all of the trauma out there.
You seem like a joyful person.
Yeah, we
do. Despite what you've been through.
Yep, we do prioritise being happy because I think it's something you have to actively do. My greatest happiness is my family. Family times, I don't think there's anything better than having a tight-knit, close family, people you can rely on and count on. And I just, my children are my absolute joy, and I can't wait to carry on my life just making their lives happy and being part of it.
Oh, it was a lovely kōrero. A bill to make surrogacy easier was drawn from the ballot in Parliament on Thursday. Now, this will give hope to Toni, as she's long advocated for surrogacy laws to be tightened to protect intending parents and surrogates. The journey, as she says, is fraught for all. Toni speaks in more depth about that and the impact on hers and Sophie's relationship on our Facebook and Instagram pages, Sunday TVNZ. And Toni's book, Lost and Found, is out this coming week.